If you want to make science interesting, you have to be fun with the students, but at the same time, don't lose sight of the science that's behind it, and that's not always so easy to explain. So not oversimplify it. And at the same time, it's sometimes difficult because you don't have time to set up experiments. In some countries, for example in Germany, they are alone teachers, they don't have help to set up experiments, and when you only have 5 minutes between two lessons to set up an experiment, for the students to have a hands-on, it's very difficult to do. So teachers need time, and they need time to train, because you have to keep up to date with all the discoveries made in science. So Science on Stage is a network. We have for the moment 32 countries, mostly Europe plus Canada, and we exist for more than a decade. In every country, they choose the best projects. This project then go to the European Festival. There we have, of course, a little competition, but it's not about a competition. It's about sharing. The teachers share the experiments among each other. And then when they come back, they can do follow-up activities. They can meet again and develop new projects. They can do workshops. We had, for example, in the last 2 years, we had 170 workshops almost. We produce teaching material, which we compile in booklets that you can download and that we distribute as well to the teacher who come to the workshops. One thing that we have to do, and we do it, for example, in our last coding project, which we are promoting now, is to have primary and secondary school teachers working together on common subjects. And this way, they can learn from each other. In our festivals, we have teachers from all the levels who work together on this festival. So a secondary teacher can see what primaries do, primaries can see what secondary or higher level teachers do, and we have university people coming and make conferences, so anybody can look what's it's new in science. Teacher is really the base, so you have to train teachers well, you have to give them time for training, and you have to give them the opportunity to go to workshop. For example, when we organize teacher training somewhere, we have sometimes this problem where a headmaster say, no, you have 1 hour to teach, so you don't go to the whole day of workshop. So I think that's very important. Give the teacher time to train, to get the best experiments, the best experience from other teachers. And keep in mind that you can't just cut down the costs. Education is not a cost. It's really an investment for future.